ମ୍ୟାମ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ କରିବା କି?
Yes, sir.
ଓକେ, ୱି କ୍ୟାନ୍ ଷ୍ଟାର୍ଟ। ଓକେ, ସୋ ଗୁଡ୍ ଆଫ୍ଟରନୁନ୍ ଡିଅର୍ ଲର୍ଣ୍ଣର। ଟୁଡେ ଆଇ ୱେଲକମ୍ ମିସ୍ ସାଗରିକା ମିଶ୍ର ଟୁ ଟେକ୍ କ୍ଲାସ୍ ଅନ୍ ଏମ୍ ଏସ୍ ଅଫିସ୍ ଆଣ୍ଡ ଅପରେଟିଂ ସିଷ୍ଟମ୍ ବ୍ଲକ୍ ଟୁ ଅଫ୍ MP7। That is IT for business. So I welcome Ms. Sagarika Mishra to take class, and I hand over my session to Ms. Sagarika Mishra. So ma'am, please start the session. Thank you.
Thank you so much, sir. Let me tell all the learners, first of all, welcome to this session. All the learners of PGDIM, PGDMM, as well as PGRDM. Before going to start the class, I let you confirm that due to the resource person is unavailable for some such circumstance, I am taking the class. So if you have any doubt relating to the class, you can ask me at the latter part of the session, right? So as Himadri sir has introduced us, so we are going to read about your block, that is IT for business, and block 2, which is your MS Office as well as a view of operating system, right? So before going to the brief of an operating system, in the previous class, as Karvel sir have discussed with us about the computer fundamentals, the requirement of a computer, the requirement of IT, the requirement of IT in business, in today's life, in industries, and various aspects of your computer and the information technology. Sir has discussed about the bridge between your information technology and how that will be incorporated in our business world through a device called as a computer or a laptop or a mobile, right? So when a question arises of interfacing with any system, with any device, then there will be the concept of computer application will be involved, okay? So computer application, what we can say that how to apply any device that is named as a computer or a mobile or a laptop in our day-to-day business to get the output of your technology, to get the benefit of the technology. And that's why we can find a bridge between information technology and the computer application system, right? So in today's class, we are going to discuss about the back end, the behind of the system, how it will work. As because we have know that in our day-to-day life, there will be a process, a system, which is called as our life cycle, right? Similarly, in technology also, whatever device, whatever system is incorporating, it will go through a specific lifestyle, a specific life cycle. So on behalf of that, we have to be briefly understood what is going on behind the system, how the system will take the command, how the system will understand the command, and how the system will get the output or perform any specific operation, right? So on behalf of that, let me share my screen first. I hope it is visible to everyone. Right? So this is our today's topic, that is MS Office and operating system. First of all, we will go through the various theoretical concept of operating system. Then we will move to what is MS Office and how we can interact with the day-to-day small operations using our MS Office application, right? So what is our operating system? Before going to the operating system, you have to first understand what is a hierarchy. And before going to the hierarchy, you have to understand what is the relation between a hardware and a software. As we know that, we can say hardware is tangible, that will we can touch, we can feel. It is a combination of some electromagnetic materials, right? Similarly, when we are discussing about a software which is intangible, we cannot touch, we cannot feel, but still there is something which is executing to produce the output. So in a layman language, we can say that hardware is a heart and the software is its soul, which make the heart perform or which make the heart operating, right? So going to the types of software can be briefly divided into two different type of category. One is your system software, another is an application software. Look, here each and every name has its own specification, right? So when we are saying that system software, that means a software which is dependent or which is used by the system itself for operating its own operation, right? Whereas application means which you are going to apply. That means the user will apply that software to perform its task. So according to the category wise, why we divided these two only the system software and only the application software? Because as previously I have told that a device and a human. So we need an interface. We need an interaction between two different things. One is a system, one is an electronic device, another is a lively human. And human language cannot be understandable by the system, as well as system code may or may not be understandable by the human being. So in between we need an interface, and that role of interface will be played by your application software. For any user, it must need an application software to perform its own task. That means, suppose we have to hear a song, we have to listen a song, then we need some software that can able to understand and play the MP3 players or MP3 files, right? Similarly, if we want to edit our picture or if we want to draw our picture, we need a specific platform or we need a specific background, that may be your MS Paint, that may be your Adobe Photoshop, any application through which we can able to make modify what we want to perform. Okay, so there are various application software categories are there. Remember always, whenever the term application software involved, that means there will be a involvement of a user. Without the user, the application software cannot be perform anything. But in the other case, whenever there will be a name called system software, that means there is no involvement of any user. The system will perform its own task through this system software. Okay, so when we will go to the hierarchy of system software, broadly it is divided into three categories. I'm not saying that it is exactly divided into three categories, but it is broadly divided on basis of its specific functionality. So what are those? The three broad category of system software are: one is operating system, second is your utility software, and third is your language processor. Okay, one can ask me, if the system software is only related to system, then why again it needs some different category, right? So yes, there will some need of some category, because system has to perform a specific task in specific timing. You cannot say that always the system will perform everything in every moment, right? So whenever we need to operate the thing, we need to control the hardware, or the system need to control its peripherals, hardware and their operation, there the first operating system will be used. Okay, so as it is named, we can simply define as, what is an operating system? A system which will help to operate or to perform something, that will be called as your operating system. Next come to your utility software. Okay, everything cannot be always performed by the control unit or by the system only. Okay, for various type of tasks, it need again various different type of file. So those peripherals files that need to be executed, those are called as your utilities software. Okay, suppose for we will take a different example. There will be some circumstance where there will be a bank, and the bank have to operate its various operations, just like your withdrawal, deposit, savings, etc. Similarly, there will be, let's suppose, another field which will be called as your entertainment field, where you need to record the audio, record the video, edit the audio, and for that you need different things, right? So in that case, the utility software will play a great role, where they will support advancedly the operating system to make its operation easier. Okay, to make it understandable by the operating system. So these are categories are called as utility software. Similarly, the third category is called as your language processor. I guess all of you know about computer language. It will be divided into three categories: high level, middle level, and low level, right? High level, assembly language, and machine language. So whenever we take a system, we know that system only understandable the machine language, which is a combination of some electric bits in the form of 0 and 1, right? But when we are writing something, or when the operating system will execute any task, it always understands the binary language. But whenever it will produce the output may not be feasible in binary language. So for every programming concept, when a programmer is writing something for performing a task, then it needs some language processor. So each and every language processor is once again a mini operating system which can dependent upon a specific language. For example, we can say that for Java, we can take the example of JVM. Without JVM, even if the system has an operating system, it cannot able to understand your Java language, or it cannot able to execute your Java program, right? So for that, you need the JVM. Similarly, for various other programs, you need a specific front end, you need a specific platform, and that platform is called as your language processor. So though all these three category, that is your operating system, that is your utility software, or your language processor, they are controlled by the system, hence they are in the system software category, right? Similarly, when we come to our end, that is your application software that the user is using, so it is again divided into two category on basis of its performance. Okay, so what is a general purpose and what is a customized? In general purpose, we can only say that the maximum the Office package, which is mostly used as the general purpose language, the basic common operation that a user want to execute, that is called as your general purpose language, okay, or general purpose software. When we need some advanced customization, we need some advanced 3D animation or any type of other customization, there we need various other application software. So if we take an example of general purpose software, we can simply take the example of MS Office package, which is a combination of various application software for different operation. If we want to edit something in a document format, then we will prefer the MS Word, the most popular MS Word, right? Then if we want to perform in a tabular format, because as we are a management student, we need maximum analysis of reports, then generating the report, etc. So for that, we mostly need the Excel sheet, the database sheet, for calculating as well as analyzing the thing, right? And for that, we have MS Excel. Similarly, the report presentation. In business world, it is the most common platform to whatever you will do, you have to present it in a report format. And for that, you have your MS PowerPoint application. Okay. So as these three different software are most commonly generally used on basis of your business world, hence it will be come as your MS Office package. Right? Next, we will come to the customized software. Customized software means for specific application, we need this software. Just for example, your media player, MP3 media player, VLCW media player, for photo customization, your Adobe Photoshop is there, and various other much more advanced software are there, which are specifically built for a specific purpose. Though they need the involvement of the user, but they are having a specific purpose. So they are categorized as your customized software, right? So in this today's class, we are mostly concentrate about the operating system of the system software category, as well as the general purpose application software, which is comes under your application software category, right? So next we will move to the background of operating system. What is operating system is actually, okay, so the definition as it is written, an operating system is basically an intermediary agent between the user and the computer hardware. As I have previously told, whenever we need an interaction between any device and a human being, we need a medium, a mediatory. And operating system will play the role of mediatory and controlling the system so that the system can able to understand what the human command, right? So the next is your, it manages the computer resources. Okay, before going to the controlling part, first of all, the system must have involvement of various hardware devices. So as we take an example, if there will be a single CPU, the CPU is of no use because you cannot do anything with the CPU, right? You need a monitor, you need a mouse, you need a keyboard, you need a speaker, you need a webcam, right? So you need various devices. So how the CPU will, or how the operating system will control all those devices, that will be called as your managing the computer resources. Okay, here managing means to check its status up to controlling every instruction till it will get the exact output, right? So everything from start to end, everything is controlled by your operating system. Okay, here I have a diagram. It is also present in your study materials, in your SLM. You can also refer that. So here we have a relationship between different components of a computer system. So in the topmost, we the human user who are using the system, right? And in the down part, there will be the hardware part. That means there are some bunch of electromagnetic machines connected with each other and running through a electricity. Okay. So in between that, there will be the first which will directly interact with the human user, as it is in the diagram, it is the application software, right? I have told it previously. Application software means what the human will use to apply or perform its operation. Okay. Then again, there will be a large connection between the human directly to the operating system, one part, and through the application software, another part, right? So this is, we can say that this is the mediatory between the hardware and the human being. So it can also able to take the direct command from the user, as well as it can instruct understand the instruction that the application software will play. Okay, then what is the behind of operating system? Operating system control various other system software, or you can say that operating system will take the help of various other system software to perform its goal. and as well as simultaneously it will be connected with the hardware. So you can say that this is a complete backbone of the operating system, where the operating system will also directly connected with the front end part, with the human user part, and it also connected with the hardware system that will be called as your back end part. Okay, that these two term is the most common term in management, front end and back end. Who is the front end? What is the back end, right? So here we can say that for operating system, the application software is the front end, whereas the other system software and hardware are called as the back end part. Okay, so what it do? It's a resource allocator. So what is the meaning of resource allocator? Who will allocate the resource? Who will provide the resource? To whom? To the user, right? So here the operating system would provide or able to generate through various hardware. Hence, it is also known as your resource allocator. It is also used to control programs to prevent errors and improper computer use. Yes, controlling means not only to restrict, controlling means to smoothly executing any instruction in a proper manner, whatever input is given and whatever output is generated. The smooth operation is called as your controlling, right? So whatever error or whatever improper thing will be happened from the hardware end or from the software end, that has to be managed by the operating system. So we can say that operating system is the big boss of the whole computer system, which is handling everything, right? So another term, it is interrupt driven. So interrupt driven means, first let me explain what is an interrupt. Okay, interrupt means in a general lively example, in our day-to-day example, let's suppose we are studying concentratedly. I have an exam tomorrow and I am studying tonight in a concentrate manner, and suddenly from my background one noise or some movie song will be played in a large sound. So that will break my concentration. So that term is called as interrupt, or you can say that disturbing. Similarly, whenever the operating system will execute the program code, and take the instruction and execute them, there were some interrupt may be occur. That may be occur by the user or by the human, or that may be occur by the improper way of writing of the program. So how to handle that thing, that will also decided by the operating system. So you can say that if anything happened, what to do? An action and its reaction, that has to be controlled by the operating system. Hence, it is also called as interrupt driven. But most of the interrupt driven, that will be, that should be managed through a program point of view, because in most of the case, operating system will try to solve the interrupt or to try to handle the instruction smoothly. But still, if we have some program anomaly, if we have some the anomalies in our program code, then that cannot be solved by your operating system. That you have to rectify in your code. Still, it is called as your interrupt driven system, right? Next, we will discuss what are the main functionality of operating system. So first functionality, that is the most basic functionality of operating system, it boots the computer. Or in layman language, we are a most common familiar word, that is called as BIOS, B-I-O-S, and its full form is Basic Input Output System. So what is a BIOS? It is a booting process. Whenever we are switch on the system, that may be your laptop or desktop or a mobile, whenever you are switch on your device, the operating system will check all its peripheral devices, all the hardware and software connected inside the CPU, that will be refreshed and checked, and that system is called as your booting process or BIOS. Okay, so the job of the booting process is to make or get ready all the devices to accept the instruction, right? So the next function is your user interface. As I have told, for interacting with the system, you need an interface, and an operating system will play a vital role for interface or for interacting between the user and the system. That can be done through your command line or graphical user interface. Okay, so what is a command line? Command line means that you have to write the command. That will be a command prompt, a black and white screen where for everything you have to write the command. Hence it is called as command line. Once you have written the command in a specific format, then only the system will able to understand it or able to execute it, right? But when we are come to the graphical user interface, it will be more colorful and it will be more user friendly. How user friendly? All of the options are available above the in front of the user, and the user has to just click on the event. No need to remember any command, no need to take the traditional black and white command line program. It will be more colorful, customized, and easy to interact for a layman concept, right? So that will be called as your graphical user interface and command line interface. Next is your process management. So here I need to describe you what is a process. A process is a mini bunch of instruction to perform any specific operation, right? In a layman concept, we can describe that if we have to make a tea, so there will be a process and there will be a specific step to make your tea, right? Similarly, whenever the program or the system will execute some operation, to perform those operation, it need to execute either a single instruction or some bunch of instruction. And how that will be managed, that will be called as your process management, right? So as it is written, creation of process, deletion of process, detection of the instruction, in which step the process is executed, then suspension, resumption, everything will be managed by the operating system. So according to the user demand, it has to choose the specific instruction or operation. Next is your storage management. Not only we are only executing any program, we have to store our data, because as in a human body, we have a memory to store everything, that is bad, good, everything. We have to store it in our memory. We have to memorize it. Similarly, for system also, it need to store its data. It need to store its program. And for that also, operating system will play a vital role. So it is also, the function is storage management. So what it will do? It will keep track of the memory, where in a sector format or in track format, where the specific data is stored, then which one is currently in used and which one is not used, allocates and deallocates the memory space. If the memory space are not used, so how to deallocate or how to make the memory free, and everything what a program is needed during execution, that it need to manage the storage. So it's another function is your storage management. Okay, then resource management, managing the various peripheral devices such as mouse, keyboard, etc. So here the BIOS process is done, the booting process is done, where it will manage each and every hardware devices connected with itself, right? So hence it is called as your resource management. Then data management. Now come to this point, most of the students are get confused about the storage management, about the data management. So there will be a thin layer of difference. Storage management means related to memory part, right? How the data will store, where the data will store, location of the data, then how to retrieve the data from the location, all those categories are from your storage management. But when we are come to the data management, it keep track of the data in the storage devices, right? It will have to remember its path. Then the how the data will be manipulated, how the data will be executed. Suppose we have to run a program, we need some data for input, we need some storage for the program. But when we want to share our data with another, we need to send it through the email, or we need to upload it to the internet. So what the data format should be? The format should be feasible to the platform. So on basis of that category, how the data will be packaged or maintained or encapsulated, that will be called as your data management, right? Storing of data, location, these are called storage management. When is how the data will be manipulated or changed its format so that it will be feasible for the platform, that will be called as your data management, right? Then the last one is your system management. Manage the basic working of a computer system, thereby making it even more efficient. So actually, why we need a system? We need a system to make our job perform more efficiently, more easily, and in a time-consuming manner, right? So that a same task cannot be repeatedly performed by a tedious manner. Hence, we are using a system. So on basis of that, your system has to be managed in a such a format so that it can be make our day-to-day operation in an efficient manner. And these are the following most popular, system management category. That is your security management. Why we need a system? Because we want to store our data in a secure manner, which cannot be altered or integrated by any other user. So for that, we have to give it a password. We have to store it in a specific zip format or blah, blah, blah. Right. Then command interpretation. Command interpretation means in which field, in whatever we are using the field, the system must understand what the user want to give a command. And that has to be capable or understandable by the system. And according to that, the data has to be executed. Right. So in that case, we can say that it is command interpretation. For example, suppose we are opening a browser or we are opening any website, a homepage of any website. So in website, whenever we are taking the mouse pointer or click on some menu, then some action will be happen and something will be performed. Either a new page will be open or either some instruction or some menu bar will be open. So that will, by clicking of the user, an event will occur, and through that the system will take an instruction. That is one type of command. But suppose you are in your desktop screen and you are continuously left clicking your mouse. So that will not perform anything. Yes, if you are right clicking, then it will open a pop-up menu. But if you are left clicking on a blank area of a desktop, it doesn't understand anything. So it is not taking any action because there will be no action is performed. Okay. So in that concept, your command interpretation will be followed by your system in various platform. Then job accounting. Nowadays, everything will be automated. In every field, we are using the computer system for performing various tasks, right? So for accounting process, for calculation process, for analyzing process of huge amount of data, where a various mathematical interpretation is there, in that case also system will help us to perform a tedious calculation in a simple manner, in a time consuming manner. So in that case, you can say that it will be more feasibly perform the task, which may be taken more time by a human brain, right? Next, overall system performance. Whatever need we have in nowadays, let's suppose in this quarantine time, suppose we don't have our smartphone. So even we cannot imagine our life, what we will do without our smartphone. Because even if we are inside our house, through the smartphone, we can able to reach the whole world. We can able to watch movie, we can able to perform our task from work from home, we can able to visit whole world, we can able to know what is happening in which part of the world. So everything will be maintained by a small device called as a system. Okay, so that will be called the overall system performance. It can able to perform anything what the user want. Okay, except eating. Next is your maintain usage record. Whatever we are doing, we must keep track of that. That is called as your backup. For future use or for safety purpose, we need a backup. And opting system will help us. The system device will help us to restore everything in a backup format so that we can keep track or we can review our performance later on. So these are the specific areas of managing your system, right? Or managing the operations of the user through your system, hence it is called as your system management. Okay. Next, we will move to your types of operating system. Look, whenever we are saying about operating system, mostly Windows 7, Windows 10, or Linux, these are only comes to our mind. But no, there are a various type of operating system who are used, and again they are classified in various type of category. And what are those? First is called as your batch processing system. So what is, as I already discussed, what is a process, right? It is a set of instruction to perform some task. And what is a batch process? Batch process means where same task is performed, but the data will be different in each time. That means similar type of group of tasks will perform at a same time simultaneously. And for that, we have our batch processing operating system. And the best example of batch processing operating system is your billing system. In any mall, you can say that in any mall or in any payroll system, there are various counters are there. There are various systems are there. Okay. And all are performing the task of calculating the bill, right? Let's suppose take a Forum Mart. There are various branches of Forum Mart all over India, all over the world, right? And they are following a same software for their billing system. So in a specific time minute, a huge amount of task will be executed, but the type of task is same. So hence it is collectively taken as your execution will be taken in a batch wise format, and hence it is done by your batch processing operating system, right? Then single user operating system. Remember Nokia 1101 set or any mobile set that will be before your Android system. It is a small GUI screen, and whatever task you will perform, mostly it is performed in a textual format and very small amount of graphical user format. Okay. So if I am opening the message, I have to be in that message. If I want to open my contacts, I have to go back to the menu, and then again I only open my contacts. So that type of operating system will be called as your single user operating system. Here it doesn't mean a user means a person. Single user means at a single time the operating system can able to execute a single type of task. Multitasking concept is not there, hence it is called as your single user operating system, right? Then the next 1, 2, 3, 4, multi-user, multitasking, multi-processing, and multi-threading. These are the four basic categories of operating system. But whatever we are using, let's suppose a Windows operating system or Linux operating system or Ubuntu, Windows 10, anything, whatever we are taking, you cannot specifically say that Windows 10 is only multiprocessing or Windows 10 is only multitasking, because all the operating system nowadays we are using that consist of these four categories simultaneously, right? So here, that's why I am not giving the example of this specific categories, because each and every operating system what we are using, they consist of also multi-user, multitasking, multiprocessing, right? So we have to just know what is the thin layer of difference between these four? Okay, first we are going to multi-user operating system. Multi-user operating system means there will be multiple system desktop are there, executed by multiple person, but the controlling will be done through a single processor. So in that case, it will be called as your multi-user operating system. That means suppose there will be a single CPU and the systems are having more than one peripheral devices, they are connected to the same CPU. But remember, these multi-user CPU is much more higher capable comparing to our own desktop CPU. Okay, they are in network based, hence they can able to control all the users specifically. Next is your multitasking. Yes, I can say the example of multitasking. Nowadays, in our mobile, let's suppose in our desktop or laptop or mobile, we can performing any Word document. Simultaneously, we can play the song through your media player or VLC media player, right? Simultaneously, I can switch to another application to open up another file. So at a single time, the operating system can also handle the music files. It can also handle the text file. It can also handle some other type of file like the executing file. So in that case, you can say that it is multitasking. Okay, it can able to perform multiple tasks at a single time. Next, multiprocessing. Like the batch processing, here also multiprocessing means simultaneously a huge amount of execution will be performed at a time. But what is the difference between batch processing and multiprocessing? In case of batch processing, the type of instruction for all the bunch of data is similar, right? But in case of multiprocessing, the types of instruction as well as the type of data is different. Hence, it is called as your multiprocessing. Mostly Windows NT software or Windows Vista software, these are your multiprocessing based, right? Then multi-threading. Here, thread is a new term. Thread means a minute process. Thread means a minute instruction which is executing currently in the operating system. That will be called as your thread. So whenever any operating system will able to perform multiple process executing, so in the behind, multiple number of different threads are executing simultaneously. So that can also be called as your multi-threading operating system. Mostly Windows Vista and your Unix, Linux, these are your multi-threading and multi-processing system. You can view the difference. Suppose in your system, you have two different operating system. One is Windows and another is Linux, right? When you are in Windows operating system, you cannot view the files of the Linux operating system held. Okay, you cannot able to search those files that is present in your Linux system folder. But when you are in a Linux system operating system, from the path, you can able to view what files and folders you have stored in your Windows operating system through your user menu. Okay, so that can allow, the Linux system will allow you not only execute the files which is present inside the Linux system, rather it will also allow to execute or view the files that is present in some other operating system called as Windows operating system. So in that case, you can say it as a multi-threading or multi-processing system, right? Next, the next three, which is your real-time system, embedded system, and distributed system, these are the most advanced system, but based on the above four system. Okay, so what is the real-time system? Real-time system means the system must be able to take some decision in a real time. What it has to done, what action it has to perform, it has to be decided in a real-time system. That's why it is called as real time operating system, the railway reservation system, the air traffic control. If everything is smooth, then the instruction is okay. But if some interruption is done during the air traffic, how to control it and how to take the decision, that has to be maintained by the operating system. And similarly, the various operating system help in your space research. All those are categorized in a real-time system. Okay. Here, the user or the human interface may not be there, but it has to automatically take some decision. Similarly, the embedded system means the miniature of your multiprocessing system, which is mostly found in our Android mobile or in our smartphones or iPhones. Whatever operating system, they have the capability of multiprocessing, multitasking, but in a miniature format, but in a lower or small scale format. So we can say that it is embedded. Also, these are also used in our nowadays your smart devices like smart air conditioner, smart refrigerator. According to the environment, the air conditioner can be low or can be high. According to the humidity or according to the weather, the refrigerator can able to adjust its temperature, its various parameter. So in that case also, your operating system, miniature operating system, will incorporated with the devices, and those are called as embedded system. Why is these are called embedded? Because they are installed in some other devices, hence it is called as your embedded system. Okay, combining the two is called as an embedded. Similarly, in distributed system, any banking system which is connected with internet, whatever we are performing in our home and whatever we are performing in a bank specifically, that has to be maintained in a same scale, that has to be maintained in a single device or in a single platform. So for that, we need the distributed operating system. Why it is called as distributed? Because the controlling is in a central part called as the server database, but we can able to extract the data in different part in a distributed manner, rather that is in our mobile phone, or rather that it will be in our laptop, or rather that will be in the bank counter. Whatever action we will perform, the same will be updated in a single central database, and hence it is called as your distributed operating system, right? So these are the various categories of operating system which is needed, where, how, and when, in what format the data need to be extracted, and based on that your various type of operating system will be used in different field of your business. Okay. Next, we will move to the hands-on session, not exactly the hands-on session. I will just overview what are the various aspects of your MS Office package. Remember, it is a software package. That means you have to be choose a specific software application from. You cannot run MS Office or you cannot use MS Office from MS Office. You have to choose a specific software, a specific application software. If I want to perform any document manipulation, then I will prefer MS-DOS. If I want to make a presentation like this, I have to dependent on MS PowerPoint. If I want to do something, then I have to related to picture or image, I have to go to the MS Outlook, blah, blah, blah. So a combination of various software, utility software are combined together, that will be called as your MS Office. Okay. So in our OSOU, there will be our LMS platform called as eGyanajyoti. And there we have briefly discussed about everything related to MS Office in a course called as IT Skills. So in today's class, I am going to demonstrate you some of the basic objectives, why we need this type of concept in the LMS platform through the eGyanajyoti concept. Okay. So I suggest all the learners to please visit our eGyanajyoti.com, the LMS platform, where we have the various 10 different LMS courses, and from among them, one is your IT skills, where you can briefly get over all the IT related or whatever your topic, IT for business, you can get all over in the concept. So here I am going to first discuss you related to the MS Word. What are the tabs used in the MS Word? Because no need to describe MS Word. All of you are the smartphone handler, so you are well known more than me about the usage of MS Word or any document application. So no need to just say that click on all program, then select MS Word, then blank screen will appear. Nothing to discuss like that. We just concentrate on the specific tab. Why this tab is there for what purpose, right? So as you can see, here I am opening the home tab. Here, home tab, whatever shortcuts or whatever menu is present in the home tab, the same thing almost you can able to find in MS Excel as well as in your MS PowerPoint, right? So everything, I guess, no need to discuss about the bold, italic, underline, strike through. So these are well defined here to set the paragraph align, middles, what tab is used, to highlight the text, what tab is used. These are various built-in tab already available to make the customer performance more efficiently, right? Next, what I need to discuss is your that mostly not used by us in a common concept, that is your five page layout. Okay, let me so now we are in the page layout tab. Okay, in the page layout, there are some of the controls or some of the icons we have used mostly for theme. So what is a theme? Look, whenever we are opening a document, it will be a white background document. There we can write our text. Okay. But if we want to customize our document, then we can take the help of the theme concept, which is present in the page layout menu. Okay, so from the theme, you can choose any built-in theme to make your document more presentable. Then margins. Whenever we are writing something, mostly we are depending on the ruler or on the scroller. Okay, but if we want to make our document a customize one having a specific footer, header, left margin and right margin, then you can perform through your margin thing. Okay, so again in page layout menu, there will be a concept called margin, or in the header part also, here it will be called as your margin. Just follow my mouse pointer, here the part is margin. Okay, so from here we can able to set our margin properly. Similarly, orientation. This is used to set orientation. Whether you want to print it in a landscape manner, in a horizontal manner, in a A4 size paper, or you want to print it in a landscape manner, what orientation you want, that will be defined in the orientation page. Similarly, size. How you want to view the document, whether it will be feasible to your A4 size or any other OPD format. Then columns, breaks, lines, it is mostly used by us where we want to give a line break, where we want to end a specific page and starting a new page, or where we want to break the page into different parts. There we can use these various concept called as size, columns, breaks, etc. Okay, so mostly the way I am discussing it, why you have to understand why you want the page layout menu. right? If you want to perform any customization relating to page, I am not saying about relating to data or text, okay? Relating to page, that means page border, page footer, page margin, page color, page orientation, page theme, page indent, page spacing, whatever page related documentation you need, you can able to get it from the page layout menu. Okay. Similarly, there is also a design tab, which is mostly used when we are preparing any document. If we want to make it more colorful, then these are the options present in the design tab, where we can able to give the borders, we can have some specific built-in design so that we can customize our data. Look, as a management student, mostly you need some tabular data. So the black and white row and table concept is much more bold. So you can able to involve some more inbuilt customized format so that you can make your presentation or make your document more lively. And for that, you have various design document. Okay. So here you have various specification for shading. If you want to give a specific shading for different row or different column or column heading, you can able to put that. So again, another is your layout tab. Okay, one is page layout, another is single layout. So what is the difference between them? Here, layout concept means how you want to make your data share. Whether you want to make it the content should be in a center format, the content should be in a corner format, why you want to sort the document. Some of the thing which is not related to page, related to text, that will be done in your layout format. Okay. So in this way, you can able to use whatever format or whatever task you need. You have to only search about that specific menu so that you can able to get the thing. And as a last part in MS Word, you must have to save the document. Whatever the customization or whatever documentation you are performing, you have to save it in a specific file name. And by default, it is DOCX. If it is in Windows as a MS 10 package, then it will be in a DOCX extension. Okay. So these are related to your document customization. Now, if I want to do something, related to tabular format, then in that case, I have to be working on the tables. Let me show you the various options present in the tables. And before that, we have to give a definition of a table. We have to understand the table, because if we are not understand the table, we cannot able to customize the specific area. So whenever we are talking about a table, a single combination of cell, one first thing, a unit box is called as a cell. The interaction point of a row and a column, the center part is called as a cell, right? So a combination of multiple cell in a single row is called as a single row. But when we are taking a combination of cell vertically, that means it is a single column. Okay. So in vertical format, we are considered is a column. In horizontal format, we can consider is a row. So if we have to modify a total row, then we have to customize it in a row format. No need to perform specifically for each cell, right? Similarly, if we want to customize the whole column, in that case, you have to take the column format and you have to customize in a column specific format. So here it is given the definition of row column. Right. how to create a table. Easily you can click on the table icon, and whatever table number of rows and columns you want, you can select it from the box. Also, there are option for insert table. You can directly put the numbers to create a default table. You can delete a table, you can delete a row as well as delete a column, and there are various options are present. Okay, so these are the common basic tasks. I guess it is no need to discuss. Let me show you what I want. Look, this is an option changing the sorry. Changing the character width and line spacing, because for me the managing of line spacing is a great headache. So we have to understand what are the options present for specifically line spacing inside a table. Remember, as we are discussing a table type of document, so we have to be concentrated on the spacing of a table. Okay, so there is a dialog. Whenever we are click on the any cell, there will be a dialog box appear where you can able to update your content of the cell through this dialog box. So whenever we are click on the font, as all of you know, font means the text, customization of text. Font have a specific style of font, a specific size of font, a specific category of font, whether you want it in a bold format, whether you want it in a italized format, or whether you want to it in a underlined format. Also, font have the option of your subscript and superscript. Like if I want to write X square, that means the 2 has to be above the X. So in that case, it is called as superscript, right? Similarly, when we are saying about something like H2O in a chemical combination H2O, so in that case 2 has to be below H, okay, that is called as your subscript. So how you want to customize your text, for that your font option is there. You can able to perform whatever thing you want to do relating to your text inside the table. Okay, so similarly, whenever we want to print a document, it is most obvious if you prepare a document, you must want to get the hard copy of the document. But remember, whatever visible in a software format, always not exactly that will be incorporated in your hardware paper. Okay, there will be some discrepancy. So you need to be prepared or formatting the document so that whenever it will be print out, the hard copy will also look that much efficient. So for that, you have to be first customized according to the your size of paper. That means if you are wanting to print it in a A4 size paper, you have to be page layout in a A4 specific format, and then only you want to print your document. Okay, so for printing your document, the in the file menu, your print option is there. Whenever we are opening the print option, there are various categories of option are present. It is not possible here in this limited time period to discuss about each and every format. So I once again suggest the learner, please go through this materials that is available in our LMS platform egyanjyoti.in, where you can go through whatever you want, though not only in Word, not only in Excel, or not only in PowerPoint, whatever IT related, or rather than your HTML, web page, anything that will be most feasible to you people. Okay, so here it is directly written why we need the print, why we need the copies, why we need the type of printer, the description of the printer that is connected to your device. What is the custom range? in what range you want to print, whether you want to print a same document multiple number of copies, or whether you want to get the odd number of pages, or whether you want to get the even number of pages, how you want to roll over, or you want to print it in a specific page format. Everything that has to be defined in your custom range, then print one side. These are the various options. I think all of you are familiar with these options. Okay, so next we will move to the MS Excel. I just want to give an overview of the three: Word, Excel and PowerPoint, so that you can able to get the similarities of all these packages and the specification of the differentiation between these packages. So this is the intro, leave it. Right, this is the complete layout of your MS Excel screen or MS Excel application software, where there are various options. Remember, whatever options we have discussed in the MS Word, it is also present in MS Excel. That is the text concept, the page layout concept, the insert tab, whether you want to insert any shape or any diagram or anything like that. Okay. Similarly, here also the line orientation, page orientation, everything will be there as it is in MS Word. So what is the new concept in MS Excel? Here you have to understand the screen. Okay, here as it is related to tabular concept, data analysis concept, there are specific columns are there in the name of starting from your capital A to up to that, and the rows are named from numeric number, that is one. I guess row is up to 65535 number of rows in a single sheet. So what is a sheet? Excel sheet is a single page. Look here in the below, there is sheet one, that means currently open sheet, a page which is currently open. If you want to add another page, then you have to click on another new sheet, right? So always the number of sheet and the name of the sheet, you can also rename it, that is present in the below part. And beside that, you can move from one sheet to another sheet, and you can also save the document all the sheet at a time, or you can separately save them. Next, these are called the row bar, column bar. Then zoom control. If it is look that your Excel sheet is very small in font and you want to make it more zoom, then zoom concept is there, where you can zoom out or zoom in your text in the Excel sheet format or in the cell format. But the most important thing in MS Excel is your minimizing the accounting concept. No need to calculate by your own. There are various formulas are present. Through that, you can able to calculate much bunch of amount of data through a single specific formula. And that formula has to be written here in the formula bar. Look, it is in known as your column bar. And above the column bar, there will be an FX written is there. And a blank space is there. This is called as your formula bar. So whatever action or accounting you want to perform in your table, you just to remember the starting cell number and the ending cell number, and you can put that in any specific formula, right? So how to know a specific cell number? Whenever you are clicking on a specific cell, the column name above it and the row name beside left part of it, it will be visible as your cell number. Suppose I am clicking on this, the first one. So it does address of this cell is A1. That means column A and row 1. Okay, so this address is A1. Similarly, if I will click on the below, the cell identification number will be A2. So in this way, we can put the identification of the starting cell and the ending cell till how we have to calculate or we have to perform any addition, subtraction or anything, mathematical calculation, we have to put that in a specific formula. So let me directly move to the formulas. Look, suppose I want to perform a specific addition, a simple addition. This is a example is given here. In A1 cell, I am writing 10, right? In B1 cell, the value is 20. And I need to add A1 and B1, right? So either if this is a single data, I can directly calculate it myself and I can directly put it in, write it in 30 directly. Okay. But if there will be a huge amount of calculation, so always we cannot calculate in our own. That will take some time. We can, but that will take some time. So that can be performed directly by the Excel sheet through the formula. So what is written in the formula bar, you have to just click on your destination set where you want to view the output, and in the bar, in the formula bar, you have to first give a equal symbol. Remember, for writing any formula, you have to first place an equal symbol and then you have to write. So here directly I have written the starting cell value plus the ending cell value. Whenever I am giving the plus symbol, automatically the name of the operation will be displayed here. Or I can write it in a different manner. I can put it a pair of parentheses. I can write sum, pair of parentheses, in between them A1 colon B1. Right. So that is also another style of writing, and this is also another style of simple style of writing where I have to write A1 plus B1. Whenever I will press the enter key at the destination cell, automatically the answer will be displayed. Okay. So this is only from 1 to 1 cell. If I have to add a range of cell, then I have to place it in a specific style of formula. Let me show you that. I guess it is not there. So just if you have a pen and paper, you can directly write. For calculating a range of value, first of all, you have to give a equal symbol, then a starting parenthesis, then the starting cell number. Suppose I have to add some values from A1 to A20. So A1 is my starting cell and A20 is my ending cell, right? So I have to write equal sum, then parenthesis start, starting cell, that is A1, colon mark, and ending cell, that is A20, and close the parenthesis bracket. Whenever we will put an enter, press the enter key, in that, after the destination cell, the total amount will be visible. This is also can be written directly in the destination cell. That means directly you can write the formula in the destination cell where you want to exactly view the result. Okay. So in this way, you can, there are various set of formulas, and I hope in your SLM, in your Excel SLM, you can able to get all those set of formulas and go through that. If there will be any doubt, you can ask those doubts in the next session, right? Next, hurriedly, we have to move to the, I guess this is the MS PowerPoint. Mm-hmm. Okay, for MS PowerPoint, let me show you my own PowerPoint screen. Okay, here, look, the same menu bar is present like the MS Word and MS Excel. Okay, the new thing what is present in MS PowerPoint application is how you can customize your slide. What is a slide? A single page that is viewed. This is viewed a single page in your screen. So it is called as your single slide, right? So how you want to customize your slide, there are various design options are there and inbuilt designs are present in PowerPoint to make your presentation more lively. Okay. Beside this default presentation, you can also get various lively presentation slides from the internet also. Next, another most interesting part is your transition part, which is not there in your MS Word or MS Excel. Whenever we are presenting something, if there will be some 3D concept is there, there will be some animation will be there. So it will looks more lively. The document or presentation will looks more lively. So in that case, you have various transition operation, whether how you want to put one slide after another, whether it will be in a rolling concept, whether it will be in a wipe concept or in a split concept, how you want to make the design. So this can be done through your transition. Remember the old movies and their casting. Whenever any movie will open, there will be various customization of casting. Nowadays, the casting timing is very minimum, but previously, whenever we are watching an ancient movies, the casting part is taking minimum 5 minutes and there everything will be in a customized format. And mostly those are done through your PowerPoint presentation where you can able to get a mostly lively thing. But nowadays, that is obviously obsolete because we have more 3D, 5D animated options are there. So we can make our presentation more lively. Okay. For animations also, there are various animations field are there, as because I am not using, because the more animation you are using in your presentation, your number of slide will be increases as well as your timing of each slide will be increases. So according to your requirement, it is suggested that put minimum but efficient number of animation and slide transition for your presentation, so that not only it will be look more lively but also it will be feasible as well as time consuming. Okay, so with this I think I can able to give a view of the MS Office packages. And as all of you are mostly the management students and you are mostly working with all of these things, so whatever doubt related to these packages or this thing, you may ask me so that I can able to describe it briefly on a specific format. Okay, with this, we are reaching at the end part of our session. And thank you very much for listening me such patiently. And if any learners have any specific queries, they can ask me or write in the chat box.
Thank you, ma'am, for a great session. So student, if any student can ask any questions, then they can ask directly to ma'am, or otherwise they can ask through chat box. I think there are few students are there. One question is there, ma'am, that is operating system choda au other system software. I think device driver is another example.
Driver, whenever we are installing any software program, any language program, we need to install the device driver, right? Just a common example, whenever you are inserting a pen drive, there also a device driver which will execute first and then only the operating system will able to detect that pen drive. So for every hardware device, whenever there will be a requirement of identifying the device, you need a device driver software. So that is also a part of your system software.
Another question is, what is the difference between storage and data management?
Right. And I have discussed it previously. Look, when we are talking about the storage, that means how we kept the data, where we kept the data, how to locate the data, and how to retrace the data. Right? That will be called as your storage management. Jemtiki, suppose ame ghare gote jinso rakhichu. Mote gote jinso dorkar. To mu seta cupboard re rakhichi. But I have to remember mu seta cupboard bhitre rakhichi. So that jete bele seta dorkar padibo, mu cupboard open kariki taku bahar kari paribi. So that is related to your storage. Whenever you are storing the data, you have to keep track of the location of the data so that when it needed, it can be traceable. It can be archived from that location. That part is called as your storage management, right? But what is data management? Suppose you have a data, you want to work on it. At that time, you want the full data. That is the complete data. But if you want to share the data over internet, or you want to send the data through your Gmail account, then at that time you must need to compress the data. So what will be the modification about the size of the data? That is called as your data management. Here there is no thing of tracing or location. Here only the concentration is size. How many KB or GB you needed? Look, just an example. Whenever we are filling off any online form fill up, why we have instruction that the photo that are going to upload, that should be in a size of minimum 2 to 20 KB or 2 to 30 KB. Why that instruction is given? Because if you directly put your passport size data, that size will be maybe minimum of 100 KB. Okay, but if all the form fill up students will having such huge amount of data, then the server will be much loaded. So it is instructed that you have to first compress your file in between a specific range, and then only you have to upload that in the online form fill up. So in that case, it is called as your data management, right? So I guess there will be a clear difference between your storage management as well as data management.
Okay, ma'am. Next question, ma'am. What is utility software? Give an example.
Okay, utility software means those software that will specifically designed for a specific operation, right? For example, if I want to get a editing of some videos, okay. Only without the any other software, simply using the operating system, I cannot able to edit those videos. Suppose I want to crop the video or cut the video or edit its resolution, I cannot do that. For that, I need some extra advanced software that are called as your customized software. But behind the customized software, what are the system program needed by the operating system? That is called as your utility software. So for example, if I am taking Adobe Photoshop, the Adobe Photoshop is my customized software for the user, for me. But what behind the action is performed through the Adobe software and the operating system, that part is called as your utility software. So we can say that the various other system software that are involved with some specific style of customization is called as your utility software. Another example, suppose we are taking the example of online electric bill payment system, right? Nowadays, as coronavirus is there, we have to pay our bill in an online mode. So let's suppose the Wesco utility software. In Wesco utility software, you have specific option to pay the bill. But how they will extract the data, how will they extract, that part will be called as your utility software. Okay.
Okay, ma'am. Next, last question is there. That is, how to calculate number of days in Excel, VLOOKUP and VLOOKUP function?
Yes. There will be one is V lookup, one is H lookup, and another is lookup option are there. So in that case, you have directly option for calculate number of days, number of seat, number of data. The data analysis part will be done in your V lookup, H lookup. Let me just another session for specifically the lookup table, so that I can briefly demonstrate you the total requirement, what is the requirement of lookup table, as well as how you can able to perform the V lookup and H lookup formula. But I suggest before that, you must go through your SLM study materials, where briefly it is described in a stepwise step format with graphical images. So you can able to get that. If it is not possible to understand, then for sure I will be demonstrate you the V lookup and H lookup in the next session. Okay, in today's class, as I have to cover up all the things of MS Office, so it is not time consuming to demonstrate each and everything.
Next is, what is the meaning of threading in OS?
Okay, so in normal sense, you can must able to understand in operating system, a single unit of instruction that is executed is called as a thread. A single operation, whenever we are performing some operation, that means we are executing some instruction, right? So a single instruction that is currently executed, that is called as your thread. So whenever we are performing any task, we have a process, and inside a process there are number of instruction. Currently which instruction is executed, that will be loaded in the thread, and that is called as a single thread. So we can say that a single unit of program that will perform some operation, that is called as your thread.
Okay, ma'am. In one line, you can say a lightweight process.
Okay. Right, exactly. A lightweight process. Because process is a process. Sometimes a single instruction is also a process, or a bunch of instruction is also a process. So a lightweight process is called as a thread. That is the most traditional definition.
Yeah. Okay, ma'am. Thank you. Thank you for a great session. I think all the questions have been covered. So now we will conclude our session, and we will meet in the next session. Thank you very much, ma'am, for a great session. So now we will conclude.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you, learners, for sitting such patiently and listening the whole session. And I once again apologize because due to some unavoidable condition, the resource person Karvel sir is not able to take the class, so I have to take the class. So if you have any feedback regarding this class, you may please give the feedback in the Google platform. Okay, thank you so much.